This is a pre-built version of the application. So if we go ahead and run it, and we are using the weather dataset by default. So we want to calculate the probability of playing or not playing given the following weather conditions. Outlook is sunny, temperature is cool, humidity is high, and windy is true. So the weather dataset has 14 records. Of those, 5 are play is no, and 9 are play is yes. So we divide that dataset into 2, one where play is no, and another one where play is yes. And we use the Bayes theorem in order to calculate the probability of play is no given that the following weather conditions hold. So that would equal the probability of play is no. So that would be 5 out of 14, so 5 over 14 multiplied by the probability of outlook is sunny given that play is no. So what that means is we are dealing with this data set where play is no. And sunny here, we have 3 records. So this would be 3 over 5. And same thing for probability of temperature is cool, given that play is no, is 1 over 5, etc. And we divide that by the probability of those weather conditions. So we end up with this number divided by this probability. And we do the same thing using the Bayes theorem to calculate the probability of play is yes, given that those weather conditions hold. And so probability of play is yes is 9 over 14, etc. And we divide that by the probability of those weather conditions. So we end up with this number over this probability. So the probability of play is no given those weather conditions is this number, and for play is yes given those weather conditions is this number, and they both add up to 1. I will start by creating a new project. And here we will have 5 classes, an application driver class with a main method, and a class representing the data set. And one representing a feature in that data set. And one representing a feature value. And a convenience class. That will contain data for both data sets, that we will be using here, the weather and the contact lenses datasets. Now, a feature value will contain a name and a number of occurrences, and get methods for both, and a set method for the number of occurrences. And since we will be comparing a feature value against other feature values, we will have a hash code and an equals method. And the name is initialized in the constructor, and the toString method returns that name. Now a feature will have a name and a two-dimensional string array representing the data in the data set, and a set of feature values and a probability. And get methods for the probability, the name, and the feature values, and the toString method will return the name of this feature. And this is a convenience method that picks up a feature value instance from the set of feature values and returns it given a feature value name. And we will have a constructor that takes in a two-dimensional string array representing the data, and this way we will initialize the data, and a column number that this feature represents. And we will initialize the name, the data, and the feature values, and calculate the occurrences of each one of those feature values. And this method will calculate and set the probability given a feature value name, and this hash map is just used for logging. So the probability is the number of occurrences of the feature value over the length of the data minus the row that contains the feature names. Now the data set will have a two-dimensional string array representing the data in this data set, and we will keep track of the class feature, and we will have a map containing the prior probabilities. In this case, they would be the probabilities of play is no and play is yes, so 5 over 14 and 9 over 14. And the constructor will initialize the data, and we will have a get method that returns the data, and the toString method will print out this data set in table format. And we will have those two static methods that are used for logging. And we will have this convenience method that returns a column number given a column name. And this method will create a data set for each one of the class feature values. And this method will calculate the prior probabilities. And those two methods will calculate the conditional probabilities. So this method will end up calling this method. Finally, this is the code that will drive the application. So we will prompt the user for what they want to do, and if they want to calculate the probabilities, then we would parse the input and we'll have a string array containing the values, and we would put those in an instance map and call the calculate conditional probabilities, passing in that instance map. And this code changes to a different data set. And next, let's go ahead and test run the application. So we end up with those two probabilities. Probability of play is equal to no, given those weather conditions, is equal to this. And the probability of play is equal to yes, given those weather conditions, is equal to this. And those two add up to one. And finally, let's go ahead and try changing the data set. This is the contact lenses data set. Go ahead and calculate the probabilities. For age is this one, and the spectacle prescription is this one, and astigmatism is no, and tear prod rate is normal. So we end up with those three probabilities for prescription is none, or hard, or soft, given those contact lenses data. And in future tutorials, I'll discuss how to get around the zero here. And we got that since we have zero here. It's a probability of no. All of those are yes. So we ended up with 0 over 4.